Alma e James Webb sono i cavalli di battaglia dell'astrofisica contemporanea e qui a Bologna si sono riuniti centinaia di astronomi per parlare degli ultimi risultati ottenuti con questi strumenti. Tra gli astronomi che sono qui c'è Pierre Cox, che è stato il direttore di Alma, e in particolare gli abbiamo chiesto: ma Alma, serve ancora qualcosa adesso che c'è il telescopio Webb o è stato superato?
I think it's absolutely essential, and that I would say that there is a synergy between both instruments that is providing like a golden age, because the JWST and ALMA really look at completely different wavelengths that are complementary. And so we have seen already here at the conference and at many occasions that there were things discovered by the JWST that were followed up with ALMA and provided very important, complementary information. And it goes from the galaxies to the places where stars and planets are born. And I think there's a huge, wonderful future, in fact, in front of us that will, provide more and more of these complementary observations.
And so you talk about a synergy between these two instruments. And is there, for example, some result that you saw in this conference that surprised you in a particular way?
I think there are many results that are surprising. Of course, the ones that I didn't know about. But I think that the level of details, the level of, for instance, when you look at galaxies that are very, very far away, that they have all these structure, that they're like basically like local galaxies with disks rotating and whatever. And I think that there's no model really explaining what we are currently seeing at these very high redshifts. So I think there's a whole, exploration there of redshifts that are higher and higher, and where there's a lot of surprises, and I think we only saw the beginning of that. So it's, I think I'm very excited, really. And there's a lot of things that can be done with ALMA today, but also in the near and the very far future, because as you know, ALMA is being upgraded now for having more broader receivers, and so that will be more efficient, also more sensitive. But also you can think about ALMA having more antennas and making it even more efficient than it is today. And one of the things that I think is that ALMA can be improved. The JWST will never be, it will be as it is. And so there's a real, also in synergy in terms of what can be done.
Okay, so very nice. We are just at the beginning of this.
I think we are really at the beginning. And the other thing that I would like to say is that it's clear that, before ALMA, there were also all sorts of instruments, including, instruments that are currently working like NOIMA. But ALMA really set the scene there, and in terms of exploring the early universe, doing the deep fields, we heard about aspects,
yeah.
And also, we haven't heard about it here, but the everything that is protoplanetary disks, how planets are formed, ALMA was absolutely revolutionary in that, and set the scene there that is continued with the JWST and is being further developed with ALMA.
And if you could choose one open question, since we still, as you say, we are just at the beginning in our understanding of this in this era, is there one open question that you would like to have an answer that still we don't have?
I think that there are many open questions, but since this is basically about a high redshift early universe, I think there are two questions: is how galaxies are really formed. When a galaxy is formed, what does it look like? All these issues about the nature of clumps, about all that is how is the evolution? What can we learn more on that? And another question that I'm always being fascinated, and there's no real answer. We know there is a lot of dust in all these galaxies very early on. How is it formed? What is the nature of that dust, and how does it evolve?